from Cast Iron. It's the 29th day of December 2004. We're at Chez Central Rural School in beautiful downtown Chez. We're here for Lake Placid Blue Bombers and the SS Seward Spartans in the 8th annual Chez Holiday Basketball Tournament. And of course, SS Seward, almost one of the powerhouses in New York State, state champions a couple of years ago, under the tutelage of this fella right here, former Chez Central Rural School standout, Rob Gravelle. And that's a skinny little Rob Gravelle over there. He's lost some hair and, like many of us, gained a little bit around the middle. But he's back here in town, and he's brought the Seward boys with him to play the Lake Placid Bombers in the first round of this tournament. In the next game, it'll be Chez against Keene Central. Many fans in attendance tonight, we have Mr. Bob Gravelle, who just renewed his viewer patronage, and we want to thank Bob for doing that. I also see Doran Fenner over there, who may have been coaching back when Rob was playing. Certainly teaching school here at that time, and may have been a coach during Rob's illustrious career here at Chez. The officials will be Al Rose and Tim Leary. And we're going to be really up the creek here as far as trying to keep track of these players. We have two teams we are not familiar with. Not sure if... I don't think we know when Northeastern played at Lake Placid, so we haven't done Lake Placid this year, and we certainly haven't done SS Seward. They were state champions two seasons ago, and they defeated Mariah in that championship game. First shot of the game taken, put back up and in. Taking the shot was Hoyt, and the rebound was put in by Brian Focal. full court press. Well, actually a three-quarter press, smaller gymnasium than what these teams may have been used to. Hogan Birney inbounds it, gives it into Ryan Marshall. Another kick. Reset that shot clock again. 35 second shot clock. Marshall misses the shot, ball's tipped out and controlled in the backcourt by Jared Marshall. Shot put up by Birney, rolled out of bounds. And we want to thank once again, there's Gerald Blair seated in back of Jan Davis over there. We want to thank the school superintendent, Gerald Blair, for providing us with electricity here after all these many years without it. We now can plug in, and I'm going to worry about batteries running out during the course of the game. It's been about a year since this electricity has been there, but another thank you is certainly in order. As we wrap up the 2004 here on this 29th of December, we'll be back probably, good Lord of willing, tomorrow night for the consolation and championship rounds of this tournament. Seward is highly favored to win this tournament. Ball goes low, pass out in the paint. It's going to be over and, oh, nice save. The Bombers keep it, shot it rattles in and out, and rebounded by Focal. It was a nice save there by Ryan Marshall when Ramsey Manning tipped it out. That's just good by Brendan Myers. And it's 6-0 Seward. .536 and counting here in the first period. Keep the ball rolling. Banked in. Off the glass by Joe Hoyt. Send it for Manning. Spartans take it away. Time out on the floor. Orange ball, and it'll be inbounded by Chris Dagel. Hoyt, a three-pointer, and it's 11-0. The Bombers are still looking to get their first point of the game. Just barely beating the 10-second clock. But the Spartans steal it, and basket will be good. And Hoyt will go to the line. Looking for the three-point play. It's quickly 14-0 in favor of SS Seward. Back of the iron, he goes out of bounds. Stolen by Marshall into the forecourt. Looks like the Bombers are intimidated. 4 minutes are gone, only halfway through this first period, and it's already 14-0 Seward. Ramsey Manning definitely intimidated under there. Passed it back outside and got caught for the 3 second violation in the paint. Hoyt's shot is missed. Stolen away by Dagley. And basket's good by Mickey Collins. Larger court would definitely aid Lake Placid's efforts here. They just don't have any room to hide from this SS Seward team. Hoyt with another bucket. It's 18-0 in favor of the Spartans. And Bombers are on the scoreboard. Brian Malone gets the pass from Manning. Spartans come right back. And Hoyt scores. SS Seward to make it 20-2. And I think it won't be long before we get into the Spartans bench here. Count the basket. Rebounded by Samanovic. Am I close? Samanovic? Samanovic? Thank you. Hoyt tosses it up to Collins. And Dagley is fouled. Press Republican giving this some coverage. Rob Fountain and reporter Keith Kane are here. Photographer and reporter giving this first game some coverage. It's a local boy brings his former championship team back. Well, actually, he comes back and brings the championship team with him. Dagley with a basket. 23-4 as a kick. Minute and a half to go in the first quarter. No travel. Malone will shoot. Both shots are missed. Rebound pulled down by Myers. Quick shot, and it's good by Collins. 25-4, they're a quarter away to the century mark with a minute 11 on the clock in the first period. This is Shane Madusky. 53 seconds to go in the first period. Short. This is good. Not sure if it was Collins or Myers who was under there to put that one in. 27-4 now, 35 seconds remaining in the first quarter. Malone will shoot. Second one is missed. 27-5 is the score. Spartans keep it. Push was called on Myers. 6.5 seconds remaining in the period. Oh, 27-5 after one here on Hometown Cable. All right. Only Placid was wasting their time. Melrose put the ball down. Gave them 5 seconds to throw it in. They beat the clock. Basket for the Bombers by Jared Marshall. Collins hits them both. And the Spartans take it away. Off the back of the iron. Bombers keep it. In the paint. Shot is missed by Bernie and put back in. And it's 29-9. Collins at the line. Five. Marshall with the ball.
I reach in.
Marshall shot. Rebounded by Collins. 3-point shot is off the rim. Kept alive. Grabbed by Hoyt. Yeah. Feed. Hoyt to Focal. I believe Bob Gravelle. That's Bob, not Rob. Bob Gravelle told me that Hoyt's brother scored 45 points in that championship game 2 years ago for the Spartans. Fadeaway, nothing but net by Shane Medusky. Or Medusky. Bernie scores. 34-11, 5 minutes and 7 seconds to go in the first half. Hogan Bernie lays it in. It's 34-13. That foul shot. We're filling with our camera here. We're on tight quarters here at Chazy. And we're probably going to be in even tighter quarters for the next game when Chazy plays, because they only opened up one side of the bleachers here, one half of the bleachers. 4:37 on the clock, 35-13 to score. Seward has not pressed since the latter part of the first quarter. Throws it up and it'll be offensive. And it's a 1-1, but it's an offensive foul, so no 1-1. Offensive foul is not a shooting foul, even in the bonus. Yeah. Marshall with a bucket. 35-15. Layup was missed by Samanovich. Marshall's shot is missed. Marshall follows and puts it in. 35-17. In and out by Marshall. Ball was brought down the floor by Justin Gallo. Gallo dishing off to Marshall, but the shot was in and out. Nothing is falling for Seward. Blocked on a shot attempt by Travolsti. Basket's good by Samanovich. 37-17, back to a 20-point lead for SS Seward. Michael Mervin in for the Spartans. 2:12 on the clock. We're in the second quarter. High off the glass. Rebound. Brian Malone at the line. This is the front of the 1-1. Bagley. Low, pushed back outside now. Hoyt at the line. Hits the first. 38-17 the score. Hoyt hits them both. Walchak in, replacing Hoyt. Hoyt ball. Minute 11 remaining in the half. Three-pointer is good by Gallo. There's 39-20 with 54 seconds on the clock. This Dagley with the bucket for the Spartans. Shavasti will shoot. So 1-1. Knapp in for the Spartans, and he gets the rebound. 32 seconds to go in a half. Will the Spartans work for a final shot? No. No, they take it right to the hole, and Mark Mancini with the bucket. 43-20 now. Spartans get the ball with 11.8 on the clock.
Let's go, Chris. 10 seconds.
Called the shooting foul. Looked like he was on the drive, but. Oh, the shooting foul. Bagley gets the first. Second one is in and out. Mervin with the rebound. Here's the buzzer. the buzzer. Walchak's shot falls off the mark. But a 44-20 first half result for the visiting SS Seward Spartans. Stick around, second half coming right up here on Hometown Cable. Viewer-supported local television. All right, we're just getting set up here. I'm chatting with Bob Gravelle at the half. And the son Rob's even older than I thought. He graduated in 86, according to Bob. And Bob, I don't know. So we've got a few shots of Rob in our archives pitching for Shazy, but probably not a lot of him playing basketball. We started taping in 83, but didn't get into a daily basis until 86 in April, which is after basketball season. So we may have a game or two. And Shazy didn't get cable till the fall of 85, so we would have had only that one season. Champlain and Rouse's Point had cable in 83 and 85. Shazy got it shortly thereafter. Moores, then Altona, then Ellenberg. That is short. It's our first time we've used this new digital camera here in Shazy.
Come on, Rob, let's go.
Dagley with a basket. And tight quarters. So we're just still in a learning situation with this camera. And every time we come to a new situation, we find ourselves in a learning process. But 20 years of holding a bigger camera on our shoulder of left us with the shoulder problems. We have to go to the tripod and smaller digital camera in order to keep doing these games.
Right up,
Ryan. I'm surprised the basket counted. I thought it was whistles before the shot, but a continuation, right up, I guess. Orange ball. Very nice color combination of orange and blue for SS Seward. Hoyt with a bucket. 51-20, 5:31 remaining in the third quarter. Shot from the baseline by Jared Marshall. Orange ball. And the paint rolls off the rim. White knocks it loose. Bagley picks it up. Three-second violation gives the ball to the Bombers. Placid moving the ball well without SS Seward's press. Hoyt will keep it, put it up off the back of the iron. Rebound is short. Second attempt is short. Tied up. Lake Placid fans want to reach, but that was all ball. He had to grab the ball.
Hey,
pushed back outside. Top of the key, pass tries to go under. And it's white ball. Count the basket. I'm going to give Joey Trombley a camera. He was at the hockey games last night. And at the basketball games tonight.
Basket's good.
Might as well put himself to use. Bagley with the basket, 54-22, 3:51 on the clock. General Tom Tobin assisting Lake Placid. He's the modified coach. Three and a half to go in the third. SS Seward, offensive foul. Seward, the school, defeated Mariah 2 years ago to take the New York State Class D title. Basket by Jared Marshall. Rob Gravelle, coach and athletic director at Seward. Left in the third period. 54-24. 30-point lead for Seward. Marshall rebounds Weiss's shot and he is fouled. Marshall hits them both. 54-26. 80 points have been scored in today's game. In and out.
Get up!
Simonovic with the putback. 56-26, back to a 30-point Seward advantage. Weiss ties up, gets it back outside. Bernie's shot is short. And put in by Marshall, Jared Marshall. From the baseline, shot is short. Bernie lays it in. Nice feed from Jared Marshall. 56-30. Minute 35 left in the third. Ball drop, rebound. Pulled down by Malone. Ball goes out of bounds. In and out. Rebounded by Mancini. Mancini again. Manning with the rebound for the Bombers. Bierney flies through everybody. That's 56-32. Six unanswered points for the Bombers. Short. Simonovic at the line. 30.6 on the clock here in the third period. Rebound and basket by Mickey Collins. 58-32. Quick jump ball called. On the line. On the line. 0.7 seconds. 58-32 after three. SS Seward leading Lake Placid here on Hometown Cable. Gallo inbounds to Marshall. Back to Gallo, back to Marshall. And the fourth quarter is underway. Place's shot is short. And Seward will get the ball. Seward will get the ball with 9 seconds gone. Maduski. Nice pass from Hoyt. Finds Mervin. And it's 60-32. Weiss with the rebound is blocked. Here comes Hoyt. Dishes off. Shot is missed. And the Bombers come out with it. This is Marshall into the forecourt. That is good. Gallo, a three-pointer. It's 60-35, just under 7 minutes remaining in the game. Opening round of the Shazy Holiday Tournament before between Christmas and New Year's. Hoyt scores for the Spartans. Eighth annual Holiday Tournament. Winner of this game will face the winner of Shazy and Keene. And loser will face the loser of that game. I believe Shady faced Seward in the semifinals of the state soccer championships with Shady, of course, this year's Class D soccer champions for New York State. So it's, rematch of sorts if they play each other. Basket by Myers, 64-35. But in order to play each other, Shazy will have to get by Keene. Then square up. White ball with 5.5 showing, 64-39 to score. 99 points have been scored thus far in today's game. High arcing shot is missed. Put back is way off the mark. And Hoyt will bring it up. Mervin will put it up. And Michael Mervin makes it 66-35. Hoyt with a steal and an easy layup. And Hoyt might come out after that steal. Weiss is a... letting it fly tonight. Greg Hudson in for Hoyt. Close. jumping in, called on Myers. Bernie brings it up. Off the rim. Let's get by Collins. Let's see, who was that, the pass? Walchak, I believe, with the pass, and Medusky setting that up to start with. Short. 3:15 remaining. Shane Medusky makes it 72-35. And a steal from Medusky. He lays it in, nice coast to coast. Stole that one in New York and put it in California. That's just good by Jared Marshall. 74-38. Mervin with a put up, nope. Rejected by Marshall. Walchak will inbound it. Oh, we got 10 here, that's Laskowski. Mervin yanks it down.
Follow it up, follow it up.
Greg Hudson will inbound, a minute 42 on the clock. 36-point lead for SS Seward. Mervin with the basket. Walchak likes to take those outside shots, but he has to turn his shoulders. He's not squaring up, so he's got to move his range in a little bit, I think, to be more effective. Gallo at the line. 1:10 on the clock. Hold call on Mervin. 107 left now. Bernie will inbound. Marshall. Yes, basket by Jared Marshall. Efforts there by Michael Knapp, now put up by Mikulski. 42 seconds remain. Bernie misses the front of the 1-1. 17.8 left in the game. Somehow that ball didn't go out of bounds. 13.4 now. 76-41 the score. Six seconds. 4 seconds. Count the basket. Manning finds Knapp for the final bucket of the game. 78-41 is the final. SS Seward defeats the Lake Placid Blue Bombers, and that's the way it was on this 29th day of December 2004. Thanks for watching, and for those of you supporting viewer-supported local television, win, lose, or draw, TV is worth your support. Our thanks to those of you who are watching and supporting our efforts.